So, you have an aircraft that needs to go. Maybe it's too expensive. Maybe you just don't have anywhere to go anymore. Maybe you need to pay for your third divorce. I hope that's not the case. Maybe somebody in the family owns a plane, but after years of enjoyment, they can't fly it anymore, and now getting rid of it has fallen to you. Listen, I hope you've just upgraded, because I love flying, and I hope you just have a better aircraft. But if you're interested in finding out more about aircraft donation and how it can benefit those in need, then this quick video is for you. Aircraft donation is what charity looks like in the 21st century. The act of donating your aircraft to charity instead of storing it in a hangar and paying those fees every month and allowing it to collect dust and worrying about maintenance and annual inspections, that stuff can all go away. That single engine or multi-engine prop plane or maybe even a jet or helicopter that you need to get rid of now has the possibility of not only helping a lot of people who are really in need, but also you can have benefits of tax deductions that can really help you. Has it been on the market for over 6 months and there's no interest, or maybe you don't know what to do because you don't have the expertise to deal with this headache? Maybe there's major inspections coming up that could cost thousands of dollars. Hey, does it need some serious repairs? Maybe the dreaded overhaul is coming that easily is $30,000 per engine. Yes, that's right. If you answer yes to any of those questions, then you may want to just consider donating this aircraft and letting somebody else deal with the hassle while they help other people with your donation. In addition to doing good in the world, you're going to be able to receive a powerful tax benefits for your donation, and you're going to see some awesome stuff happen. So if you're experiencing upgrading to another model or other issues, maybe your days of flying are over, aircraft donation is sure to lessen the turbulence ahead. What type of aircrafts are accepted as charitable donations? In most cases, charitable organizations accept almost every kind of aircraft. The most common types, of course, are single engine or multi-engine or jets or seaplanes or amphibious airplanes. Those are fun too. Classic aircraft, those are awesome. Ultralights, helicopters, even experimental or sport aircrafts. These kinds of things are the kinds of things that you can donate. In addition to parts and tools and engines and all kinds of things, charities usually are able to accept these kinds of donations and put them to good work. What do charitable organizations do with your aircraft donation? Look, this all depends on the kind of charitable organization that you decide to donate your aircraft to. In most cases, the charity does sell the aircraft and they can use that money and they can really help people with that money. Some charities may repair and refurbish the aircraft to get it ready for sale so you don't have to, but some, they might even give it to another charity. Some might be able to put it into service themselves. That means that the resale price of your old aircraft can be maximized and it can allow you to claim the highest possible tax deduction allowable by the US. Keep in mind that if your donated plane is not appropriate for the use in the field, it's still incredibly valuable to a charity's mission. In most cases, they're gonna sell it and use the proceeds to fund programming that really helps people, maybe even save some lives. One of the questions you gotta ask yourself is this charity gonna be able to handle this donation? Listen, airplane donations are super complicated. So in order for your donation to be used, you gotta ensure that your chosen charity is able to deal with this kind of thing. Do your research, ask the right questions. I found an organization called Student Reach, and we help students with all kinds of things. For instance, like suicide prevention. We've talked to over 1 million students in schools. We've mentored thousands of students, and donations like this are the kinds of things that fuel our mission. As a matter of fact, you can call us right now. Just click the link in the YouTube description or hit this right here, this number that's on the screen, and we'll talk you through it. But if not, you should have your questions ready and written down and ready to go so that when you do call somebody, you're not wasting your time and theirs and you don't forget to ask the questions you want to ask. Here's some important ones. See if they participate in regular donated aircraft donations so you know if they have the expertise. See if they have an in-house expert. See if they have a pilot. See if they're able to fix the aircraft if anything should happen to it. Dealing with the IRS. When it comes to the IRS, remember that your donation amount and your deduction amount is generally the same as the gross proceeds from the sale of the charitable organization of your choice, okay? So when they sell it, the amount that they sell it for is the amount that you're going to get. And that sometimes can be minus major repairs and some of those kinds of things. So talk to the organization that you are gonna donate to and make sure that you understand everything that's going on. You can kind of get a list of all of the schedules that you need to do and all of the things that you need to take into account. It's probably a little more and too boring for this video, but you can actually go to our blog post, which is in the description, and it'll explain a little bit more about where to find some of those things. Remember, your charity should be able to help you through some of these things. And it's important to know some of the basic rules. Getting your aircraft appraised. Now, keep in mind that you're gonna get a deduction for what the charity sells it for, but in case there's a problem along the way, sometimes it's a good idea to get an appraisal, even if it's just so that the charity fully understands the value of the aircraft. These can be a couple hundred dollars, they can be more, sometimes they can be cheaper, maybe you can have a friend do it, but it's important to have experts that understand all the factors about this aircraft. The opinion of the expert is based on experience and repeated analysis of market factors and sales of other aircraft. So make sure that when you get an appraisal, it is something that you know is accurate because it's somebody who is an expert in doing appraisals. You can find those kind of people online or just talk to somebody at the airport where the aircraft is stored. How to avoid charitable organization scams. Now listen, I hate to say this, but some scammers are out there pretending to be organizations that help people. Now, some of these actually have a 501c3 filing and they just aren't very well monitored by the IRS. So what you want to do is you want to make sure that you're getting references from clients that they have helped, that you're looking at their social media to understand what they're really up to. Any organization that doesn't have a serious social media presence saying, this is what we do, this is someone that we're helping, these are issues that we're working on, is probably not legit. And if they're putting that much work into faking it, well, then they're really good at it. Make sure that you don't let anybody rush you into making a decision. There's no time limit, it's all on you, and you don't wanna do some sort of, well, you'll miss out if you don't do it right now, all right? You can always get that deduction later, so make sure that you are comfortable. If it takes a little bit of time, that's fine. Make sure you get this right because you want that great feeling of, hey, I donated an airplane and I'm really helping people. Not that sick feeling of, I think I may have gotten scammed, all right? Make sure that they know what they're talking about, that they can get you the right paperwork. Those are organizations frequently that are legit. And listen, you can look on their GuideStar rating. You can go on their website, see if they're really up to something. See if the phone number really works, all those kind of things. I'm putting our phone number and our contact information here on this video. That's how you know I'm legit. You can actually go on our social media, which is also in the description, and check us out. See what we're really up to. You can go on our websites and see, are we really doing what we say we're doing, okay? Know your charity. Before you're choosing the organization to donate with, you should make sure not just that they're not a scammer, but they really are who they say they are. There are some people out there that just aren't legit, or maybe they're trying to be effective, but they're not. A few years ago, a lot of organizations sprung up pretending or intending, I should say, to help with human trafficking. But it turns out that's really difficult. In a lot of cases, that's the kind of work that is really done by law enforcement, the FBI. I know because I've done a lot of that work working with those organizations. They set out to do something great, but they didn't really have much to show for all of their donations. They tried, but it's difficult. Keep in mind, there's some organizations that are great at raising money that aren't great at doing anything. However, there are some out there, I would say, like our organization, Student Reach, that have experience and experts that can really not only make the donation happen, but really make sure that they use that donation to really help people. In our case, even save lives. Look, aircraft donation can be tricky, and it can also be tricky dealing with some of these organizations. So make sure that your donation goes to the right place, and just make sure that you have that great feeling when you get it done. All right, listen, hey, my name's Jeff Duvall. You can check me out on social media. I do a lot of charity work, not only here in the United States, where we mentor students that are coming from really tough backgrounds, but we've spoken to over a million students about human trafficking and suicide prevention. We work with schools, we do all kinds of things, and we've taken almost 10,000 people around the world to help other students and families that are in difficult spots. We also do trips on an annual basis to Nicaragua, to Zambia, and to Baja California, working with Oaxacan migrant workers there. So check us out. Maybe you even want to come along and volunteer with us. Who knows? Maybe we'll even use your plane to fly there. And if you have a question about another organization and you just want a third party that has some expertise, hey, we're great at this stuff. And we'll let you know if the organization you're working with is legit. There's a lot of great people doing a lot of great things out there, and we would love to see them get your aircraft donation and put it to good use. Hey, thanks for watching. You're awesome. Donate that aircraft, save somebody's life, get a great tax deduction. Do something awesome today. I know you can be more awesome than you already are.